pining for his affection, or he was pining for their affection.
They were pining for his. He was the Deltiv.
I'm sorry, come again. He was
Deltiv or something. It's something somebody else said.
Who?
One of the adults. I hear like passing rumors and such as people come and go. They said he was Deltiv or something.
Was there any of these women who left this place in a mood?
I normally went to my room or upstairs for cleaning when ladies came through.
Oh.
How old is he?
Who?
Ricky.
You can assume Ricky's around 10 or 11.
Anybody else have any questions? Salty, salty.
Is that all you need to ask me?
That's all I have for now. Anybody else?
No. Not at all.
That's all for now. Thank you.
Ackies. Got timeline being in here. Hello, Jack. We are the investigative team. My name is Carrick.
Ah, about time you lot showed up.
We had a long way to come.
Yeah, so what do you need?
Well, I'll just have a few questions for you. First one being, what time you arrived here this morning?
I came here about 8:47. The man's got quite a decent clock, so it's pretty accurate. It's one of the first people here, so I just let my raven feast while I waited for other people to show up.
Do see any others show up, perhaps? Even know the time of when they had showed up?
I don't exactly keep a pocket watch and a notepad so I can note everyone's arrival times.
But you were very aware of when you arrived.
Like I said, came in, saw the clock.
Gotcha. Who were the other guests?
You got Yonovan here. He came in pretty much just after me. Fine looking lady Lila. He then points over to where Tim's is. And then Mary, Dennis, and Ralph. They're near the entrance.
You said it was Ralph, then Yonava here?
Yeah, Yonovan.
Yonovan. And then, did you notice what order the other guests came in?
Pretty sure it was Mary, Ralph, Dennis, then Lila. Come to think of it, I think Lila came in after the murder. Don't know why she's in this room.
And Lila after the murder. And to the best of your recollection, this is correct, Ms. Yonovan?
What about him?
I'm just asking if you're corroborating Jack's story here. You appeared shortly after him.
Yeah, I got in around 8:51. I was bringing a shipment of firewood. Darius did tell us that he was having a kind of festivities going on. So I came in over some fresh firewood for him. Then he offered me to stay for a while to get a drink and probably some meat, so I stayed around.
Very nice.
You know when I could leave, or because I kind of got to get back to work.
Yes. Once we have this wrapped up here, we should go. We only questioned about half the audience so far, and we've still got some. Still waiting on some evidence to come back from the lab, so be a little bit longer. Take a drink. Alright. Hey guys.
Cyphros and Falgor have just gone off to get a drink. They're going to the bar right here.
We talk to Lila next?
Yeah, we could definitely do that.
It's true that she came after the murder, then why is she here?
You have a look. Hello, Lila. My name is Carrick. This is my associate, Falgor. We're the investigators on the scene here, and we have a few questions for you.
Oh, it's always nice when a man knows my name. You have questions, investigator?
Yes, I was wondering what time you arrived here today.
Oh, you can't possibly think I did it.
Not what I asked.
But why could you be questioning me?
It's protocol, ma'am. We just have to...
Very well. I got here around 10:11. I entered the building and that guard Wenlock over there said I wasn't allowed to leave. Apparently I was returning to the scene of the crime or some nonsense.
See. Where were you this morning prior to...
I was just walking about. I had a day off from work, so I decided I would browse the shops. I saw there was some people going into Duraus's estate, so I thought I would pop in and have a look.
I see. But Duraus knew of you, or...
You could say as such. I was trying to change his mind to courting me.
I see.
Would say, Stu, you're breaking up.
Sorry, yeah, I was like, So he had, not been forthcoming to you before?
Well, he's rather selective with his female companions. I haven't been able to sway him thus far, and I don't think I ever will now.
I don't think you will at this point. Who would you say he... Did he have anyone... Did he have his eyes on anyone in particular?
Well, if he did, he did not have his eyes on me, and I could not tell you anyone else, since he wasn't really outward with his... feelings.
But I'm assuming from what I've heard you were not for his affections.
You broke up again, Stu.
Sorry, I assume that from what I've heard from some of the other guests, that you were not the only one action.
No, there was plenty of other women trying to get his affections. So.
Here today, any of them? Any of them? Such ladies, or recognizing the faces?
The only one I could think of would be Mary, but I'm pretty sure she is with Dennis.
And, Marianne, since you're here as well, I'll ask you when you arrived here today.
I actually live here. I'm one of the servants, so I was on the second floor.
Where were you at 10 a.m., were you?
Well, I heard a loud noise, so I came down and I found Dryas on the floor and I screamed for a guard.
Hey, you screamed for a guard. And I'm sorry, what brought you down here?
I heard a loud noise.
Loud noise? You know what time that was about?
I didn't really check the time, sorry.
But when you came down here, you'd heard a loud noise, you came down here, found Drass's dead body.
Yes.
And then you screamed.
Yes.
So you were the first one to find the body?
There was no one else in the room besides me. I would have assumed I was, unless somebody saw it and left.
Did you see anyone while you were arriving to the scene?
Only the other servants on the second floor.
And the other servants, sorry, just if you mind pointing out the other servants that were on the second floor with you.
It was, Druff and Ricky, which then points to the two people you talked to earlier.
Did you hear anything before you saw his body?
Just a loud noise, but I can't really tell you what it sounded like.
What? Was it a bang? Was it?
Sorry, I just can't remember.
How would you describe Dryas as a person?
He was very kind. He wasn't a sort of a ladies' man like most of the others around here. He just kind of stayed away from the girls.
Did he get a lot of interest from other women?
Oh yes, he had plenty of female callers trying to make their way into his estate. He mostly shunned a lot of them though.
Do you know anyone who would have had any disputes with him?
I do not know of any enemies of his.
Any reasons why he would have enemies?
He was a rather powerful man. He did have a lot of money. I mean, looking at his estate, he had quite a lot of hold. But he was pretty much putting that all into the orphanage and trying to reform the city as a whole. He wanted to see it be better.
Hello, Timms. I wanted to ask you a couple more questions.
You found the murderer yet?
Not yet. Would like you to point out the servants of the household you are familiar with.
He points towards Marianne, Druff, and Ricky. Those are the three that are in this room.
Okay. Where were you? 10 a.m.
I was in the other room. I was playing with some toys. My father said I could stick around with the party.
Stick around during the party?
Yes, he didn't want me cooped up.
I see. So... when did... sorry, just walk me through what happened.
I came downstairs. My father informed me that we were having a party, or reminded me as such, and I just played around the house. I heard a thump and then a scream, and then I came into the room and saw my father on the ground.
Seems... how far apart hear the thump? And...
would have been a minute or two. It wasn't much of a gap, really. I mean, there was a party. I thought the thump would just be people getting a bit rowdy. Plenty of alcohol going around.
Thank you very much, Tim.
As you finish talking with Timms, you hear the shut of a door.
From which direction?
Where Charlotte is. Investigators, you returned. The murder weapon has just returned. She then picks out a dagger, which is more akin to something of a knife you would normally have in your house, and then she passes it to Carrot. We've identified that the blade was only used once, so this was a weapon just for Dryos. Either it was picked up at the scene or it was brought with them. The blood on it is just Dryos's, so there's no kind of back and forth with this. And we can tell the person who wielded it wasn't too strong. So we could definitely rule out the guardsman.
I don't believe it to be any of the children, as the stab wound was. Higher up. And for a child to do it, they would definitely aim a bit lower.
That's a fair assumption.
Dennis, Ralph, and Mary, who are they?
They were some.
I just know the names.
They were invited to this party, and they were here around the time the murder happened, so they're in this room.
Brass, you wanna... Are you willing to check over the other silverware? Area, perhaps check with the servants? So we can... Because I trust your eye with this sort of thing.
See if it's the same.
Yeah, see if it's from here. That would explain... That would lean us more towards a murder of passion or something that wasn't necessarily thought out. Or something much more localized than... Pass over the knife to you. I'll check in with Ralph, Mary, and Dennis here.
As you start to walk off, Charlotte kind of raises her hand. Just remember, when you do find the culprit, the laws of the land.
The laws of the land?
Yes, a eye for an eye. You have the murder weapons that you can, well, do unto them that they did to Dryos.
Alright. Good to know.
Well, I'll look at the knife, and from what I searched on the table, is it the similar design, or is it a completely different style?
It's very similar. This seems to be kind of the knife they would use for their main course.
Alright.
That's why it's more akin to a dagger from its size and the kind of sharpness to it.
Charlotte, would you happen to have a piece of parchment and ink and something to write on?
Sorry, I do not.
Damn.
I just keep most of my notes in my head.
Mary, Dennis, Ralph, Eric, this is Falgor. We're investigators of the murder called in. We have some questions for you, if we could get you to run us through what happened this morning. One at a time, please.
I guess I'll start. I'm Dennis. I got here around 9. I'm pretty sure that was the time. I wasn't really checking it myself. However, I did make sure not to be too late. So I got in. Then I just waited for Ralph to come in, who didn't really take much longer. Once he came in, we got a drink.
I'm Ralph. I arrived to the party around 9:53. Got a drink at the bar and sat down with Dennis and Mary.
And I'm Mary. I got here around 9:33. Dennis was with me when we entered, and I got a drink with Ralph.
Sorry, Dennis was with you when you entered?
Yes.
Hey, Dennis is very good at math.
if Mary says it was 9:33, it was 9:33.
Alright.
You can roll sense motives on people, just to let you know.
Yeah, Been thinking about that, and I was like,
I mean, you've talked to everyone now, and you haven't rolled once since motive.
I know, like... I guess there's three of them, might as well knock it out in one.
Surprisingly for everyone, or just one roll.
You have to use sets motive on each person.
Oh, gotcha. And the aura...
You get plus 9, yeah.
Wow.
Plus 9, okay. Sorry, well that's much better. So... Go around the Dennis, Ralph, Mary, since Quentin.
Actually, no, not says motive, sorry.
So just plus 5.
Sorry, plus
5. Oh, plus 5, okay. So 13. Ralph, Mary. Oh, man. Top of it.
Okay, Dennis doesn't really seem too sure on what time he got here. Ralph is pretty adamant. You're pretty sure what he's saying is true. And with Mary, it's, you're pretty sure she's telling the truth.
Mary, when did Ralph arrive?
Ralph was already here. We got a drink with him when me and Dennis arrived.
Drago, you got any instincts here?
Can I have Diana roll sense motive on these three? If she's been listening in.
This one is...
Okay,
Staff from Ralph, Dennis.
I'm pretty sure Ralph is telling the truth. However, Dennis, he said before he arrived at 9, then he changed it to 9:33 when Mary said, and you're not too sure he's confident in that timing. And Mary kind of changes her time from... She changes the time, she says, a bit here and there, so it's a bit kind of suspicious.
Alright.
And from looking at her and the way she's looking at the others, she's kind of motioning towards them to take up her story.
Okay, and then Diana will turn around and say, Mary, darling, I know you're lying to me and my friends here. I can see it. I can see the sweat dripping down your face. Is there something you'd like to tell us?
Yes, there is. She then takes a drink from her wine glass and then spits at Diana. Don't accuse me of anything.
What's, Falgar, do you have any bonuses, to intimidation with your cloak or aura?
That I do. Plus 4 to intimidate.
Plus 4? Okay.
Wait, the cloak is plus 9 in total.
9 total. Okay, well... Eric, surprisingly intimidating.
We'll have to pull myself and intimidate.
Well, Diana will wipe this stuff off of her face and put a hand on Mary's shoulder and say, you do know we're investigators and you have just assaulted one of us.
Yeah, Carrick's gonna smack the glass out of her hand. Cut the clap, Mary.
As Diana steps back and Bert goes forward.
If you wanna yank our chains, we'll have you in the prison cells and you can rot there for a while and think about what you did. As for you two, I don't really blame you, Dennis, because, well, is he as old as he appears to be here?
He's younger than Wiz Token shows.
Okay, gotcha. I don't know... I don't know how... what sort of weak-willed person you are. But Ralph, I see it in your eyes. You're telling the truth. I know the timeline based off of your story, so does anybody want to fess up to what actually is going on here?
Look, I don't think you know how things work around here. You're not going to put me in any cell.
No, but if I find you guilty of the murder, I know exactly what the law of the land is. Don't you?
You better hope your story matches up, boy. Mary, I think you should, be a bit more kind. I mean, they are kind of... Lord... Shut up, Dennis!
I was just here for the party. This is a bit too rowdy for me.
Oh, it's rowdy for you now, Ralph? A man is dead, a pillar of the community, from what I hear.
Yeah, but I wasn't here when that happened. I was in the other room. I've just been kept in this room because apparently I came here too late or too early.
Yes, what did you all hear around the time of the murder?
A thump and a scream.
Yeah, well, yeah, a thump and a scream.
Mary, does their story sound right to you?
I don't know, Pointy, does it sound good to you? Bringing out the racism.
Mary, you need to watch what you're saying. I mean, you do not want to anger the people who can find you guilty of murder right now. We're here to help. We're not wanting to tag anyone individually. We've been asking everybody questions.
Dang, you don't want to attack anyone individually. You've all crowded around me and started accusing me.
You threw water in Diana's face. It kind of shows you're hiding something.
If you think that's water, darling, I think you need to go to better parties.
I think you're...
Now, are you going to waste more of our time, or are you going to get to the bottom of this?
Are you going to answer our questions, or are you going to waste more of our time? Waste time, sounds good.
Did you all receive an invitation to this party?
Yes, we did. Dennis picks out a letter from his jacket and then hands it to Carrick. If Carrick wants to take it.
Yeah, I would like to take it. All right. Carrick will be like, I'd like to have you come over to Charlotte Holmes. I'd like to... I'm unfamiliar with his handwriting and I want to make sure that I have you nearby to verify this.
The letter contains basically two invitations for Dennis and Mary. And Charlotte does not know of Drass's handwriting since she didn't know him personally.
Oh yeah, this is... Eric doesn't care about the handwriting, he just wants Dennis over. A little ways away from Mary at the moment.
Dennis isn't moving.
Alright, look over the invitation.
If you think it's false, you can always,
I us, think... This is on you.
I think it would be Decipher Script. Let me check.
Yeah, actually, that might be me. Diphras has got some...
Decipher Script, yes, not Diana. Diphras, what about you? I think you can do it.
Yeah, I'd say you could roll a Decipher Script to see if it's, like, forged or if anything's out of the ordinary.
Alright.
I'm sure. Difrost could do it.
Bonuses?
Just the cloak, I think.
Cloak?
It's five.
The cloak gives everything.
All skills and saves.
Yep.
That's beautiful. Alright, Carrick's gonna look it over and passed over to Difrost to double check.
Okay, you're pretty sure this is a solid invitation. Doesn't look like there's anything out of place.
Carrick even... really wants to be wrong, so he has to die for us anyway.
It ends with a seal, which pretty much looks to what to what a nobleman would have. And yeah, Difrost corroborates that. It looks pretty legit.
What a shame. Is there any drinks on the table next to Diana?
Not on that table specifically, that's more of a food table.
Is there any soft food on there? No, never mind. Oh, it's like soup or out like that.
No.
It's mostly
fruit, vegetables, cheese, bread, and what seems to be cooked fish.
Well, it seems you were at least invited to this party. Hands it back to Dennis. Walk off for now.
How did you all know the victim?
I am one of the local alchemists. He wanted my help to kind of make potions and salves for the poor. They are rather sick as of yet, so he wanted... Probably why he invited me. I did talk to him a few times.
Which one is that?
It's Dennis.
Yeah. I make good ale. That might be why he ordered me. I do normally send him barrels and the such. I wasn't really expecting an invitation myself.
And I am with Dennis, so of course the invitation extended to me.
Poor Dennis. Difrost says that loud enough so she can hear as well.
Do you know anyone who would have had disputes with the victim, Dreyos?
Not really. I don't really talk to him in whenever he came to my shop, and I don't really keep an ear to the local gossip.
Again, ale. I just kind of worked in a warehouse. But I met him one day, shook his hand, let him sample some stuff. He seemed like an alright fellow.
Yes, he was fine. Though he wasn't very good with the ladies.
Well, thank you for now.
I'll say it loud enough so Mary can hear again and say, I guess she was after him as well, but clearly wasn't good enough.
Alright, we need to look over these notes. Go further.
Oh, okay.
Caught in the wall, I want to go over to the corner.
I gotta say, where's she gone?
Okay, I'm going floppy.
Ricky, what was this? I'm guessing this is the table next to Ricky.
Yeah, it's a table. That table actually has some drinks on it.
Ah, that's a shame. Is there any writing on this door?
Yes. On that door, it reads, Eye for Eye.
So we have to kill someone. Just kill everyone here. But one of us got to be the right person, right?
Like a whole hospice of people for one person.
You do know that if we do kill the wrong people, it's still Eye for Eye.
Ah, oh, let him try.
No. As in, you kill an innocent person, someone gets to kill you.
But then they can't prove.
What you?
They can't. They don't know if I've killed the right person or not. Only one person will.
If this was a real situation, sure. But we're in a magical tower that appears in thunderstorms. That sent a maniacal little girl after us, like half an hour ago.
With her weird teddy bear.
Don't know what to do.
I don't think that easy.
Activity on my mic. Alright, I will try. Options.
Gonna have Diana go around asking everyone random questions to see if they're telling the truth or not.
Now we know we can roll sense motive, because we didn't ask before.
One thing we could also do is gather everyone to just sign a piece of paper randomly.
Yeah, that's what I wanted to do.
Which hand if they are.
Yeah, that's why I asked if that... bloody...
The thing with sense motive is that that's something you have to ask to do. Yeah. I don't just say, you can roll it. Because it's kind of just it's something your character would do if they want to do it. You can either believe someone or you don't, or you can roll.
I don't think anyone here actually has anything to write on. I mean, we could go through the other... back to the other door, because that...
If you want to see what people's hands are, you can just, like, bring them a glass each or something.
Yeah. Okay, yeah. Good point.
Right, throw them a coin and see which hand they use to reflex catch it.
Yeah.
Here, catch! Oh! Then you just, like, put their hands on the chest to kind of grab it.
Yeah, Diana will pick up a few drinks. And bring them to Jack and... can I say the other one's name?
I feel like we shouldn't go around doing crazy stuff to everybody. I think we should narrow down who we've got. Because we've got a timeline here now.
Wait, what?
We've got a timeline. I mean, I've been writing down when what people were doing when.
How dare you make notes?
Yeah. I'm not rolling sense motive because I'm actually just, like, trying to solve a crime. let's see. So we've got, the doc's called in at 10:22 a.m. The murder is believed to be committed at 10 a.m. What did you find about the knife? That was the important bit.
It looks exactly, well, it's pretty much similar to the other knife we saw in the other room. It looks to be a main course, or for any tough meat and stuff like that. Pretty much anybody could have picked it up. And used it.
Yes. However, 10 a.m. is the time that they suspected. Now,
one thing I don't get, we never really figured out any proper motive. If he was such a good guy, why would someone want him dead?
Money. Always down to money.
Well, that's the obvious answer, but...
Unless a woman couldn't take...
Oh, we'd have to double check. I mean, like, that's the thing, is like, we should narrow it down into, like, the people that we're looking at. Because we got Prin, who says he saw a shadowy figure that was an adult entering at 9:30 a.m.-ish. You know, like, that's his timeline. With an aura of evil. Enter the place.
A shame that other people aren't around anymore.
You know, there's the thing is like...
Well, he can only do that so many times a day.
Can he, though? If he's a paladin, I thought that was just an at-will ability.
There are different types of paladins.
Okay, fair enough. I just wanted to double-check if my character could roll something to know something more.
No, from what you can tell, this kind of setting is in the past, so they could have used
paladins
different magics and
here.
Stuff.
Okay. So somebody entered the place around 9:30 with a bad aura about them. Wenlock heard the commotion and approached the scene at 10 a.m. Prin was in a different room. We might want to double check with him because he's got some important info. Cleaner Druff, I do want to double check with him to make sure that Lila was up there with him, that like he had seen Lila upstairs with him, because Lila said that both him and Ricky were up there upstairs with her too.
Lila was the woman who came up to the scene at 10:11. Marianne was upstairs.
Marianne, sorry, yep, Marianne.
Marianne's the other servant.
Yes, Mary, that's who I'm thinking of. So Marianne, so I know the important part is that there was about 2 minutes between the thud and the scream. Everybody else's timeline for the murder starts at the scream. But the 2 minutes prior to that is the important one. like it's a couple moments. So the murderer killed him and then got out of the scene, got out of the room beforehand.
My money's still on Mary. She said that the guy was bad with the ladies. However, everybody else says he has a lot of women after him.
He said that?
Mary did, yeah. What's the name of it? Yeah.
Well, I think that's interesting to me is that since...
And she's definitely hiding something.
Started at about 10 a.m.
And they were here before that.
My gut instinct is that Ralph is telling... is the closest to the truth.
Yeah, Ralph is.
So 9:53 a.m. is when he arrived. And... Dennis claimed that,
they were there before him.
Yeah, that he showed up before him, but then he changed his tune pretty quick as well.
That's what I was saying. Mary's definitely hiding something. And again, the whole, she said he was bad with women, however, everyone else who had mentioned anything about women have all said they was after him.
The only time I asked why would anyone have disputes with him, they mentioned that he has lots of ladies pining for him.
Exactly.
Mentioned that. Yeah. Remember recording him, but he didn't really care about that.
And then Mary seems really stubborn.
Kyla said Mary was with Dennis.
Every time Dennis...
Oh, is with Dennis.
Yeah. Dennis was about to speak up until Mary shut him up. What hand was Mary holding the drink in?
Her left hand.
Mary did it, the score killer.
But there's multiple people, lying about their timelines. Cleaner Duff says Jack showed up around 8 a.m. Jack is adamant that he showed up at 8:45 a.m. Yonovan was shortly behind him. And Yonovan says that he showed up at 8:51 a.m. So that's closer to Jack.
Yeah, so... Duff could have just been a bit off. I mean,
but then they say Mary. Then they say that it was Mary, Dennis, Ralph.
Mary, Ralph, Dennis, Lila.
Yes, and then Lila showing up after the murder. But nobody's story seems to match up with Prin's. The interesting part to me. I mean, if Prin saw a person with a bad aura walking to the place at 9:30 a.m., and the only other person who claims to have entered at 9:30 a.m. was Mary.
Exactly.
And she came with Dennis.
Whatever mentioned she, Prin arrived.
What?
Nobody ever mentioned seeing Prin arrive.
Nobody, huh?
You could always take a drink to him and then just say thanks for your hard work. See what he takes it.
Prin has his weapon in his right hand.
I double checked with Prin about the guardsman, but I didn't double check
the guardsman with about Prince.
Yeah, I didn't have the guardsman double check Prin.
Then again, the weapon analysis said that it's probably not a guard. Because the attacker was weak. Or at least not very strong.
Yeah. So again, Prince, who's clearly carrying some heavy armor, would be able to give a nice swing with a little knife.
Yeah, Prince is pretty much wearing full plate, just without the helmet right now.
Yeah, but if we're not getting the correct story from him, even if he's not meaning to lie, but he's just incorrect in his information, then we are getting a mixed story.
We could go ask him if there was a chance there were more than one aura when he saw the bad one. I mean, Mary seems to be a bit of a bitch, really. However, Dennis seemed nervous.
Make her a murderer.
Yeah, but if we ask Prin if there was a second aura nearby, or a weaker one, that could be Dennis.
I think the important thing is to find out if there was multiple people. Did he see an aura and multiple people? Or
yeah, that's what I mean.
Yeah, all right, that's a good start. But then I would like to follow up on what Falgar said about nobody having mentioned Prin having entered.
Also, if when Jacqueline said other people, if Mary and Dennis coming together. Seems unlikely because wrote down correctly, Mary came first, then came Ralph, and then came Dennis.
Yeah, so is there a chance Dennis saw Mary, and now Mary scared him?
I don't know.
But from their talk, the very first version was Dennis came in first.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yes, Dennis said that he arrived at 9 a.m. Followed by Ralph. But he said shortly by Ralph, and Ralph said 9:53 a.m.
So...
yeah. Almost an hour, he said shortly.
Alright. Let's double check with Prin. Prin, I've just got one more thing I've got another thing I need to check in with you about. You said you saw an aura, or a shadowy figure with a bad aura, correct?
Yes. I saw a figure. I didn't like the look of them, so I used my sense evil, and they had an evil aura, so I decided to follow them.
Okay. And was it just the one figure that had entered?
Yes, I'm pretty sure it was just one person. When I saw them, they were alone. When they entered, I'm pretty sure they were on their own. I entered shortly after them, and nobody went in between their entrance and mine.
Alright. Good to know. And you arrived here when again? I'm sorry.
It was around 9:30.
Okay.
That's when I got a look at the clock.
Gotcha. Alright, thank you very much.
Yeah, wow.
Double check with Winlock real quick. Hello, Winlock. I wanted to ask you about that armored fellow over there.
Grin?
Yes.
What do you want to know?
I was wondering when you had first seen him on the scene.
They were here when I got here. Because I heard the commotion, and I called in. I came in, actually. I saw the body, and then I called for Charlotte. Prin was already here.
What do you mean they were already here? Or did you just mean him?
I meant Prin, yes. Prin was here when I entered.
Gotcha. And you know of him from the community?
Yes, Prin is from the Church of Pelor. They normally cross with our patrols, so I have seen him here and there.
Gotcha.
Is Pelor a good god, would we know?
Yes, Pelor is a good god.
Yeah.
If this was a normal D&D campaign, Pelor would be the dominant god.
Mm.
Yeah.
Drifters. So if I wanted to go over what you had done this morning one more time.
Of course, sir. I was cleaning in the servants' quarters.
Yes, and that is on said... the...
Yes, the second floor.
Yes. And were you the only one cleaning up there?
In the part I was in, yes. However, I did see both Marianne and Ricky cleaning their respective places.
Okay.
However, Marianne did leave. She ran down the stairs and she screamed, so we all came in after her.
Do you know why she ran down the stairs?
Well, now I do. Apparently, that was when she found Dryos dead.
So you and Ricky had followed her down the stairs.
Yes, after we heard a scream, we came down, and we'll assume it was her, because she was the only one there to scream, and that's when we all found the body, but obviously Marianne found it first.
Gotcha. So you had not seen her go downstairs?
No, I did notice her leaving, but I just assumed she was going to talk to the master.
Gotcha. Do you know what time that was at?
I was busy cleaning, sir. It could have
what
been
about,
around...
What about her pace, her temperament?
She looked to be, a bit of a rush.
Okay. Bit of a rush, alright. Good. I wanted to check... in with you about Jack. You said Jack had arrived at what time again?
It was around 8:30. I was just finishing up cleaning here, and when I left, I saw him enter.
Around 8:30?
Yes, checked the clock, talked to the master for a bit, and then I left. It could have been a bit after 8:30.
Alright. Very helpful.
He was the first guest, so...
That should be...
And remind me, when was the party set to start?
The party was meant to start around 8:30.
Okay.
So Jack was pretty much on time, or just a bit late. Anything else?
No, I don't have anything else. Anyone else have any other questions?
No.
Okay. Sorry to bother you two gentlemen again. I want to revisit which room you were in.
You gotta give us a time.
Yes, the time of the murder, when you heard the scream.
We're in the other room with most of the other guests. I mean, drinking and eating.
Could you identify the other guests that were in the room with you?
Pretty much everyone here, and the other people who are still over there.
The other people who are still over there.
When you entered this place, Charlotte said the people in this room didn't have solid alibis, so the people who do are in the other room waiting to be released.
Gotcha.
Actually, to say one thing, Lila wasn't there. He came in after the murder, but I'm pretty sure you got told that already.
Yes.
The same with the doctor. He was called in afterwards. And the guard, Wenlock, he wasn't in there either.
Alright, that sounds about right. I guess, do you have any knowledge or relationship of the other guests in this room here?
Well, we all pretty much live in the same city, so we do pass each other here and there. The dentist is kind of the physician? Is it physician or apothecary? He's one of those that deals with potions. Ralph, I don't particularly know him personally, though he says he works in an ale shop. From the smell, he definitely seems that way.
And Mary, what is her,
I ain't one to talk about Mary. She's not my, type of fellow.
Which one is this?
Wait, this? Fellow?
This is Jonathan.
Any particular reason for...
Just a bit brash.
Yes, I can tell that. He kind of looks back at Diana, stain on Diana's shirt. Or blouse. What about you, Jack?
Yes, as Jonathan says, pretty much the same. Not a big fan of Mary, but I've had a few drinks with Ralph. He's a good guy, even though he is a bit big and green.
And you... know Ralph's work within the...
Yeah, he works in he looks in a alehouse of sorts.
What do you mean of sorts?
I really haven't been there myself. I just know they make ale. Or store it or something.
I see. Thank you very much for your help. Can I talk to you guys again one more time here?
Says, meeting! Town meeting!
Town meeting. I'd like to know if anybody in our group has alchemy skill set.
No.
That would be a craft.
Okay. Let it double check. I guess we can check in with the doc, see if he...
If you don't have the crafts, you could always try a heal or nature.
Nature's my only hope.
Depending on what skill you use, is going to be what kind of information you get.
Yep.
Well, let's double check that real quick. I want to make sure that, the knife isn't just a ruse.
What do you mean?
I want to make sure it's not an after the fact sort of attack. I mean, we have a man from an apothecary. We have an apothecary here, and then a man from a supposed brewery or alehouse. No. Nobody's actually ever been there.
Have you been to an alehouse?
No.
It's not really something you would enter. It's like something you would go on a school trip.
Right, no, I...
Ralph's been the most honest with us as far as we ever were. About his side of that story.
Yeah, I mean, out of those three people, he seems the most... determined, but I would like to double check the body.
All right.
I mean, you guys don't have to join me if you don't want to, but I'm going to do that. Doc, is there any evidence to support something having killed Dryas other than the knife wound?
I couldn't see anything else on him besides that. The wound.
Have you checked him for any toxins?
From what was his body, yes, I couldn't find anything like that. Pretty much the dagger cut through his chest, cut some arteries, and basically messed up his insides. Couldn't really continue living on after that kind of attack. There's no smell or any sign of signs of the poison or alchemical substance.
Pull that out. Alright. Well, I guess we could double check with Charlotte Holmes here and see if she has any other leads or any help, advice to offer. Difrost just stares at Mary over Bert's shoulder. Well, Charlotte, with the... pardon me. We are finding that some people's alibis are not quite as strong as others.
That is why they're in this room, yes.
I would like to know your assessment of the situation from when you had gotten here and any investigation that you'd had up until this point.
Anything in particular, or?
I suppose we could start with Mary, Dennison, Ralph's stories. Had you questioned any of them prior to our arrival?
I was mostly investigating the scene itself. Besides the people, that's why you lot were called in. I did talk to everyone here, and they had the weakest stories, so I kept them in this room. They probably told you as much or more than what they told me.
And,
my God's sake.
Did any evidence stand out to you upon your arrival? I guess since you are more of the physically sleuthing one, that type of detective.
To be honest, you've probably found more than I have.
This is to see if Mary's a man or a woman.
Why? Okay.
You never know.
You look Mary up and down from behind, and from looking at her dress sense, you think she's a female.
Dress sense doesn't mean anything in this world.
Exactly. Unless you want to go underneath her clothing to see what kind of part she has, you're not going to know. But you're pretty confident she's a female. Just because I can't do female voices doesn't mean everyone's a man.
No, it's just that... what's his name? Jack, I don't know if you did it by an accident or something, but he said, like, the way he spoke, it was like he was.
He called Mary a fellow.
Yeah.
Yeah, fellow doesn't have to be a man.
Right.
I guess. Gather around, everyone. Does anybody know? Has anybody been able to spot people who are left-handed? Which ones are left-handed? Which
Mary.
Ones are
right-handed?
Okay, Mary's left-handed.
Their tokens pretty much show what kind of handedness they are.
Ralph,
Dennis, and Mary are all holding things with both hands.
Well, Mary had the drink with the left hand.
Yep.
We've got Tim's, who has the stick or whatever he's using in his left hand.
Some sort of toy.
Yeah.
I knew it was Tim. God damn it.
Gotta break his legs.
Jordanheim, what the hell? The guy next to Jack, he's holding the thing in his left. And that's his dominant.
Holding a log in his left.
But that would mean he's a strong guy, so I'm ruling him out. Could be the cleaner. I mean, wait, how would you hold up?
Which cleaner?
Duff.
Cleaner Druff.
I'm just trying to picture how I would hold a brush. Like, would I? I can't picture it in my head.
He's holding the broom as if you would hold it right-handed.
Right, so he's right-handed. Weapons left. He's got torch in his left. Shield. Is Ralph holding the rag or the cup in his left hand?
Ralph. Ralph has the... Let's have a zoom in. He has the cup in his left and the cloth in his right.
Right. So that's his right hand dominant. So that leaves us with Mary... Tim's. Marianne has. Tim's. Yeah, how big is Tim's?
Tim's isn't much taller than Ricky. Tim's is about, you could say, 13, 14.
I know some tall ass 13, 14 year olds.
This is fantasy. People no longer grow when they're like 12 to their highest height.
It's Mary. My vote's on Mary.
Marianne has not been holding anything?
Well, I can't
Marianne
see.
Marianne has nothing.
Yeah.
You can go up to her and give her something to hold if you want.
Diana has two drinks. Okay, Diana will give Marianne a drink.
Okay, Marianne takes the glass with her left hand.
Well,
Marianne will begin to drink.
So we've got Marianne and Mary.
Yeah, but...
Was Marianne on her own? I can't remember. Like, she was the
I
one who...
was the first one on the scene.
She said she found the body, but no one else in the room.
The room was empty when she arrived.
Yep.
And she heard a noise, but she can't remember what this noise was. She can't even give a faint description.
Fear can be a horrible thing.
Yeah, she was in a rush. I mean...
Well, a noise what would make you run to check it out would definitely be something you'd remember.
True.
People are different.
I mean, it was a loud noise, so you could have assumed it was like something breaking as she went to clean up.
Mm-hmm.
Why would she run?
I don't know. Because she's a servant and it's her duty to keep the place clean.
I don't think they'd run to it. And this guy doesn't exactly seem to be whipping his servants to do the best job they can.
Maybe they want to prove themselves to him.
Yeah.
Be the best like no one ever was.
Well, with your arguments, it would be... I'd look back to Mary again.
Okay.
I've been on this so long.
I will check... I'm going to check with Ricky real quick about Mary.
You wanted more diverse puzzles, so I gave you one.
Yeah. One. I'm gonna go check with Ricky about Marianne.
What would you like to know, sir?
I'd like to know how long Marianne's been working here. Ricky.
About a year now? Maybe? He's been here at least as long as I have.
You've been here.
Yes, I was adopted for at least a year ago, and I've been working just short of that.
Okay.
And was she already working here when you arrived? Or did she come after you?
No, Marianne's been working here longer than me. I'm not sure how much longer.
And what would you say her feelings towards, damn it, what's this guy's name, Drayon?
Dreos.
Dreos. Her feeling towards Dreos were?
As far as I know, they were friends. I mean, she never complained about working, eh?
And what about you? You're very young to be working so hard. I'm wondering who took care of you? I know Dreos was your adoptive father, but who are the ones who helped you day in, day out?
Well, Dreos didn't force me to work. It was an option. He said he would pay me just like any other servant, so I took the job. If anyone was to take care of me besides Dreos, it would be Marianne. She is the one of the older working servants here.
Well, thank you for your help, Ricky. Check in with Druff one more time.
Difrost is just staring down Mary. It's her. Then characters are pointing to everyone.
Yeah. No. Where did I go? Druff, I was wondering about some of the other staff. I heard that, I know that Ricky's been here about a year, give or take. But I know little of yourself and Marianne.
Oh, well, like I said before, sir, I've been working here for just about a week. Marianne's been here. I think she's been here longer than the young boy Ricky has. She definitely kind of acts like the older servant, but she kind of treats us as equals.
Gotcha. How do you mean she acts like the older servant?
Well, she knows how things work. She tells us where objects are placed, how Dreos liked things being cleaned. Like, she wasn't bossy, she just told us what we should do.
Gotcha. And do you have any idea how long she's, you have no idea how long she's been at this. Do you know, what sort of standing she had with, Dreos?
They were friendly towards each other, sir. I wouldn't say anything beyond that. She was very diligent with her work. But that's only about a week of me knowing them, sir.
Thank you very much, Druff. Okay, so, hey guys.
Ask Marianne herself.
Yes, we could. Here's my notes.
All of the backstory, please.
Go paste real quick.
Jesus.
You're welcome.
Sorry if we have made a note or something.
Yeah, I could just made a handout for all of this for you.
That would be pretty helpful.
I didn't expect you to spend so much time just on this one puzzle investigation thing.
Well, I knew you still was like, he has to know everything. I'm really brash, I just jump to conclusions.
Are you sure it's just personal?
Hey. Same thing, right?
She spat wine at me, that must mean she's the killer.
She's lying.
I don't disagree, she's the most suspicious of everyone in here.
I could have Bert kill her right now.
She's a bitch doesn't mean she's a murderer.
It does. Bert could end this all right now. And technically, I'm not the murderer, Bert is.
Bert won't be able to do it.
Why?
He can't hold a knife.
Oh, it got to be
with
a knife.
Yeah, we have to stab her because it's eye for an eye.
I can summon someone with a knife. Or can hold a knife.
Come on.
Well, if anyone... Bifrost gives Diana the knife.
I like how you give your cohort the knife.
Yep.
So it's not your character.
Don't care. Diana deserves
such
it.
Cop out.
So you're willing to risk your wife for a personal vendetta?
Yeah. It's personal to them both. Especially Diana.
I'm sorry, how long had Diphrus and Diana been married?
I don't know. I don't know how this whole bloody age with the elves and...
I mean...
They can't even be married, but they are...
They can be married at their age, but people don't know the ages of elves yet. I mean, as far as everyone else is concerned, they're adults, but as elves, they're like, I don't know, 14?
Yeah. That's illegal in some countries, so about 2 years. They got parents' permission, so as early as they could do.
You don't have parents. No one's old enough to be your parent.
All these teenage parents.
Exactly.
It's almost as if it's real life.
Mm-hmm. Alright, I'm back. You guys figured out yet?
Yeah, yeah. Mary died.
Well, Fish wants to kill Mary.
You're pretty dead set on that, huh?
Yeah. And Diana's got the knife, so it's on a time bomb.
How is Marianne looking?
I mean, under her dress, you can't exactly look her muscle definition.
Oh, come on, servant lady.
I mean, you could...
Working your whole life, I would...
Oh, I thought you said Mary, not Marianne.
No, yeah, Marianne.
Marianne, well, she's a servant, so she does have some sort of muscle definition, but she's not exactly a bodybuilder.
Asking Yanovan and Jack if they could... remind me what they told about the other guests and when they arrived.
They repeat what they said before.
That, which was?
After them, Dennis came in, then Mary, then Ralph, and then after that, Lila came, but that was after the murder.
Now it's Dennis, Mary, Ralph.
They said that before.
Did they?
They should have.
Mm.
Alright.
So Mary came on her own.
So Dennis, Mary, did Dennis come in alone?
Yes.
Did. Alright. Did you see the paladin come in, Prin?
Yes, but I didn't think you meant them as a guest. They kind of went around asking if we saw a figure, but we think they just kind of had a bit too much to drink, I mean. Who just goes around asking about a figure.
Alright, when did he come in?
About 9:30-ish? 9:40?
So same time as Mary.
And that was before or after which guest?
He came in before Ralph.
Or Ralph, alright.
Mary. But, us two, Dennis, Mary, and some other people were here.
Now, some people have been saying that Rayos was almost quite popular with women.
Oh, definitely. I mean, just looking at his estate, who wouldn't be pining over him?
Mary.
Would you include Mary to be part of those women?
Ain't Mary with Dennis?
Do you know if Mary was at any point interested in Treos?
Not me personally. I'm just the fireman. Well, the woodman. The firewood man.
Sense motive.
Jack?
You can sense motive if you want to, yeah. Jack pretty much says the same.
Yeah, but my sense motive is terrible.
Falgor, all you gotta do is pick up a mirror, look at yourself, says, I know what they're saying. Well, that mirror's also cracked.
Okay, I guess. But yeah, my sense motive is too.
Falgor knows how good he looks.
Damn, good. And damn, these guys are lying.
He's a handsome half-orc for a reason. not a nice reason, but a reason.
They seem as if they're saying what they know to be true. Whenever you talk about Mary, they don't really seem to be that all happy about talking about her.
Do you know if Mary and Treos had anything, any reason to hate each other?
I didn't really know Mary myself. Dreos, he was pretty much friends with everyone. I wouldn't see them being enemies of sorts.
So the reason for Mary for being here is just because she came with Dennis.
If that's what she said, then sure.
Alright, thank you again. I will go talk to Marion. How long have you been working here?
It's been about 3 years? It would have been coming up on 4, but I don't think I'll be employed for much longer.
And how did you come about to being hired?
Dryos was actually asking for servants and people for house cleaning and cooks, and I jumped at the chance.
And what did you do before working for Dryos?
I was just working at my mother's tailoring shop. I just knitted small clothing and scarves and the like.
And how old is Marian? How old does she look like?
Marianne looks to be between 20 and 30.
Person's motive.
Sure.
What?
Yeah.
When you need him, eh?
You give yourself a devilish grin in the mirror, and you just know what she's thinking.
Time when I killed Sebastian twice. Yeah.
Just want to get to the bottom of this.
Listening to Marianne, she seems to be trustworthy, and she's being truthful in what she says, and you can sense that she has a bit of sadness towards Dreyos' death.
Alright. Thank you for your time again.
Diana will go up to Mary and say, what was your feelings towards the victim?
Mary just continues to drink and talk to Dennis.
Diana pours the drink over Mary's head.
Is Dennis actually talking back to Mary? Is he just, yes, sure, darling?
Well, Dennis is now kind of turning towards Diana and just like,
well,
His eyes happened. Are dirting.
I was speaking to you. Talking,
yeah. Actually responding with words.
Yes.
All right.
Are you about done with your childish demeanor?
Nope. So, what was your feelings towards the victim here?
He was a man who invited me to a party.
Meh, I believe you're just tagging along. You know, everyone gets a plus one. So parties work, right?
Did you get dropped on your head as a child?
Probably.
I have a personal letter of invitation.
Yeah, God, what was he thinking here? Then ill-mannered people like you in, just spitting your drink into other women's
now
face.
Now just turns away again, starts to ignore you.
Diana pulls out the dagger. Does anyone react?
Dennis, you can tell his knees are shaking.
Carrick, Falgar? Nope.
Diana, don't.
Diana, no. Please. I do not want this to happen.
I walk over to Diana, kind of glance at Davros' direction before I take Diana's elbow and just drag her away.
Wow, treating her like Vivi.
I should do that.
Just enough space, just kind of out of earshot from Mary, enough. Just like, these are not real people. Just drop whatever you have against Mary and concentrate on the situation. It's not worth it.
Well, do you two have an idea of who it could be? In my mindset.
Dennis and Mary are the most suspicious in what I have.
Yeah, they really are. Like, I want to believe that it's Dennis, to be honest.
Well, I'll let the group down.
It doesn't make sense because we don't have the proper motive.
What the hell?
Tumbleweed.
God's sake. Diana will start singing. Well, okay. Playing a horn.
You're singing whilst playing a horn.
No, she's playing a horn. She doesn't sing. She plays a horn.
Okay.
Excuse me. Let's see how close you are with that. See what I roll. Have you noticed a much better noise than that? There we go.
I don't know, I'm trying, guys, but this is where this is the time of day where my brain starts to shut down.
And with the power hover performance in her now, she will move in to Mary again.
If you're gonna do it,
you just
played
music, you didn't do anything with it.
Well, do I have to say but...
Yeah, you have to say you'll do something with music, otherwise you're just playing an instrument.
Guess you'll do it again and... To the 2D fire, 2D6 fire, and stuff.
Okay. Don't know why you're wasting a charge of this.
Yes, Vendetta.
There's.
No need for that. Do you have the knife?
Yep, Diana does.
Okay.
Carrick said okay, so.
I'm not saying no. Stu's saying okay. Stu's dying.
Sounds like Stu's eating.
So Diana will.
Stu is also eating.
Hold the knife and play with it a second as she looks at Mary and throws the knife at Mary's head.
Oh, roll to attack. See if you miss. Okay.
Plus one to that because of the song.
Dinah gets the dagger in her fingers and then throws it as if she's trying to aim for a dartboard, and it goes straight into Mary's temple. Dennis gasps and jumps back. And then time freezes.
So no one else in the room moves, or...?
Everyone besides your group has stopped moving.
Okay.
Alright, well, that was weird. Okay, we're just gonna walk over towards the door.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, let's hope you were right.
Yeah, we'll see. It's worth it anyway.
All that investigative work. And it just comes down to the person that we ended up hating the most. I'll check the door. And try and open it.
The door opens.
Yeah!
Well, that's... Those are people.
The hell?
Oh, yeah, yes, bro.
Enter into the next room, which is full of knights, warriors, we can seem to be kind of brigands, and a referee in a sort of tournament area. Just like the room you were in before, it fades in and out of the tower itself, and a floor covered in hard sand, and walls covered in a clean white marble. There are plenty of bodies scattered around, some of them kind of phasing into the walls themselves as the room kind of constrains the Colosseum to this small area. You see one knight standing tall with his sword in the sands, as if he's waiting for a match to start. There are people gathered around in kind of little groups chatting away. And on the far side, on the west side, you see a group of... You think they are lizard folk of some sort, or some kind of frog men. And they seem to be in their own little group as well. And as you enter behind these knights next to you, they turn around. Ah! You got some new blood coming in here. Well, you gotta wait your turn. Alice is up next. And, the odds ain't looking too good for him.
Where are we?
You're in the Colosseum. Did you take a wrong turn or something?
No, sorry. Who's Alistair up against? Why is it looking bad for him?
Well, Alistair's up against that Munlock fellow. And it's looking bad because, well, all the bodies around here are of humans, not of lizard folk.
Is this tournament all one versus one battles, or...?
Oh yeah, one versus one. You can't really have a battle without that kind of, sportsmanship. We're just, waiting our turn. I mean, ain't gonna be long till Alistair's just returning in three pieces.
Are you really willing to fight that Munlock? He seems to be... This is Diana speaking. He seems to be wiping through the humans, and you don't exactly look... non-human yourself.
Yeah, he's gonna get tired out eventually. My buddy got locked up earlier. Wasn't too long before he bled out and the ref couldn't stop it. Monsters, a lot of them. Alistair will wear him down. Then I'll go in for the kill.
She'll say, are you sure that's wise? Would you not prefer to back down as she rolls a diplomacy? Just a cloak in it for diplomacy.
Hello, Ganora.
Oh, 9.
Yeah, you're right. I'm just a halfling. I can't really stand up to Alice's kind of strength. If he can't do it, I don't think I could. I must be here for this match and then I'll leave. The halfling kind of looks somber that you've just kind of shot him down.
I don't mean to be mean, I just do not want a good man to die. And she rolls diplomacy to cheer him up.
He then starts throwing the dagger from hand to hand. Well, live to fight another day. I'll get a job elsewhere.
That's the spirit. And I'm guessing this is a line, by the way, so these two gentlemen in front of you are before you, or...?
Oh, no, no, we're, the referee will call in who's next.
Ah, right.
You're free to go past us, I mean, there's some time before the next match.
No.
I think I'd like to see what's on that door.
Yeah.
Yeah, likewise.
Boop, boop, do.
Okay, you go past the battlefield, and just from the corner of your eye, you do notice that most of the bodies here are just humans, pretty much torn apart in different ways. Hey, okay, Carrick, as you go up to the door, you notice it has writing on it. This one says victory.
Yeah. Ha, have fun.
And this guy is a human?
He's an armored lizard folk, however, he doesn't look as mutated as the other ones. Kinda got some armor on him, too.
Alright, well.
Why choose the word mutated?
Speak to the referee, I guess.
I like how Falgor was the one to pick out the word mutated.
Yeah. Why choose the word mutated? What do the other lizard folk look like then?
Well, they're a lot more kind of bulbous and rounded than other lizard folk that you know. They're more animalistic than normal lizard folk are. These don't seem to have a lot of human in them.
Hmm.
I mean, they've probably eaten a lot of human.
You look pretty intense.
And the Munlock fellow?
Munlock. Besides the red lizard folk, this Munlock fellow is a green one, and he has... The best description, he has Wolverine claws.
Alright.
Oh, alright, well, let's check in with the referee and see what this is all.
Ah, you must be, new contestants. Well, I'll call your name out eventually if you're signed up.
Where do we sign up?
You should have signed up before entering the, Coliseum itself. If you're not signed up there, you can't sign up here, sir.
Gotcha. Well, I'm sure we're signed up, so... are there any rules? Or is this a no-rule sort of battle?
No magic. One-on-one.
How about...
No magic. In no magic is that you're not allowed to cast spells. You're allowed to use potions and the like.
Gotcha. Alright, well, you two are out.
Diphos will look up and say, can I summon something to fight for me?
Nope, that's magic.
Shit. Well, right, good luck, guys. Hope you win.
Is it possible to fight for someone is the person called doesn't want to fight?
No. Yeah. They have once they've been called, they have to fight.
Oh shit.
I volunteer as true.
Is it just straight up death, or is a fighter allowed to back down?
That's up to the contestants. I'll try and save who I can, but if I can't, well, they entered the ring.
Shit. Ah, you.
Alright. Well, might as well sit back and watch.
Falgo, you might want to put a bit of breath in your sword.
Yes. I would like to do that.
Carrick, as you walk over that way, you notice there is a sort of a roster just behind the guy in the cartoony black armor.
Oh, this is where the sign up is. Or is it just shows what's up next?
I'll move to your side. You can look at it yourself. That's a list of people who are going up next.
Alright.
If you look over the board, it has a multitude of names. Munlock is pretty much at the top of the lizard side, Whereas Alistair is about 7 or 8 names down.
Oof.
And you don't see any of your party's names on the board.
Hmm. Victory, huh?
If you're waiting around, I mean, there's that Magi who should be around here soon. Apparently he has some stuff up his cuffs. Them lizards' colours denotes their spit of choice, so hopefully the mage's got something against that.
A mage that has something against lizard folk.
I didn't say that. He said he might.
Even though you're not allowed to use magic in this.
You can use potions. Enchantments and whatnot. You just can't, can't shoot fire at your hands. Who needs fire when you got armor like this? He then punches his chest and you hear the metal reverberate.
Mm-hmm.
Could a person cast spells on themselves before they enter the fight?
You'll have to ask the referee. I ain't no mage and I ain't asked about that.
Ask the referee.
Yes, enchantments and potions are fine.
I'm saying, would I be able to cast a spell on myself before the fight starts, yes?
Yes.
Right, good.
Alright, well, none of us are on the roster.
Would we have to help Alistair win then, do you believe?
I don't know how we would. Apparently it's one-on-one combat.
We can cast a few spells on him.
Sure.
So we just go up and speak to him then?
Sure. Do it. Carrick, you can't go getting sleepy on us in the middle of a tower. I'm trying, you guys, I'm trying.
Ah, some more knights. You'll have to wait your turn, I'm next.
Yes, we were wondering if there's anything we could do to help you. Anything you might lack in the department of,
I'll have you know, sir, I lack in no department. He then winks at Theana.
Theana just turns her head away.
Oh, I've got the gear and I've got the knowledge.
Knowledge?
Looking at this piece, I have concluded that I shall stick to leather armor. I'll just take off this, plate armor soon enough. I'll stick to leather armor to match his speed. And then I'll use my longsword to slash him down quickly. And I'll aim straight for decapitation.
I see you're not carrying a shield.
Nope, that'll slow me down.
How about a magic one? What will not slow you down?
What do you want to knowledge on?
Looking over at
the Verloc.
Monlock guy.
Well, you can inspect the bodies.
Yeah.
Alright, fair enough. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
I'm love and death.
What sort of, what am I doing? Search here?
Yes.
Okay.
I'll copy the smart guy's ideas.
Alright, 4 or 5 from the cloak? What am I getting here?
5.
That wasn't even... That was my idea, Fish.
Exactly.
Okay, so, Carrick, the body in front of you, you can tell this guy's weapon was sundered. And it was a long sword, and it split into 4 separate pieces.
Hmm. What about his armor?
You can't really tell much else on this body except his weapon.
Okay.
Thophros, that body looks like it was kind of a roguish type, as his leather armor has been torn apart by claw marks.
God, this guy. So stupid. Okay, we'll move back to the Alistair.
What about third guy?
Okay, I'll have a...
Check that third dude.
There you go.
Okay, looking over this person, his head has been crushed in, and you can tell this guy was not wearing a helmet.
I'll go to Alistair and say, I'll have Diana talk actually, because he has already winked at her, and she's got a diplomacy. Alistair, do we know his name?
Yeah, Alistair.
Alistair, you said leather armour to match his speed. She'll point to the guy on the floor. The leather armour didn't really help him. I recommend you not wearing leather. And has he got like full plate or something on now?
He has a sort of a chainmail. It looks as if he's in the process of changing it over.
Yeah, I'll say to him, I recommend you staying with the heavier armor you have. And she speaks to him.
Well, if a beautiful young maiden as yourself can tell me this, I shall do it. I shall switch out to the full plate. I'll keep my helmet off, though, just so I can get a good eye on him.
Nope. I'll stop you right there and point to the guy at the right at the bottom. Look at his head. You see no helmet?
Where is his head?
Exactly. He didn't wear a helmet like you was about to then. It didn't last long.
Helmet it is.
Diplomacy, there you go. and your weapon of choice?
That's your only weapon you have with you.
It's my most trusty one. This is Stephen, the longsword.
What else have you got?
I could get Yarlum. He's my warhammer.
Probably better, as if you look at the guy, the dead body right at the top. On the floor around him is his trusty longsword, in four pieces.
Stephen, avert your eyes!
He then puts his hands over his blade as if he's trying to shield it.
Yeah, I recommend using your hammer. Would any of my other party here have any other suggestions for this guy?
Yes, I would say go for the defensive and for the heavier weapon.
Yeah.
It is not going to help you if he rips you to shreds with his claws.
Yes, sir. I'll keep Stephen sheathed. I'll use Yarlum. Well, I'm glad you guys came when you did.
A little research never hurt anyone.
Bifrost will ask the ref. I might have to cast spells on other people before they fight.
You are not a registered mage, so no.
Don't.
So we'll have to trust his skill for that.
Best of luck to you, sir.
Okay.
Trust in yourself, trust in your weapon. That's all you can do now.
Eric, as you return to the other people, you notice there is now a mage on the premises.
Or we could buff you!
Let's speak to the mage.
Are you the mage that these young fellows have been bragging about?
People have been bragging about me? Oh, I didn't know I was that kind of a mage.
They said you had potions to help. Or you potentially could have potions to help against these lizard folk and their spit.
Oh yes, I've got I can give each knight a potion and a oil. However, that Alistair over there isn't exactly a friend of mine.
Diana will step forward.
I like how you're just like abusing your wife.
She's really good at speaking to people.
I bet she is.
Yes.
Bifrost just allows it.
Using that big charisma score.
Exactly. wow. she'll say, look on the floor in front of Alistair. Every other human who's gone up against this guy, the lizard folk, have all met their same fate. You may not be exactly friends with Alistair, but I'm sure you like some of the other people, and if they were to step in the ring, they would surely die as well. Would you be willing to help Alistair to protect the others? Diplomacy.
You notice the wizard is kind of blushing.
He is a bit old, so you're not sure how well he is with the ladies anymore. if someone like you was asking it, sure. Do you have anything in mind for what I should give him?
Well, we got told that the colours would represent what spit they use. I'm guessing the green one would use... Could we roll out to see what they choose? I'm guessing acid, but...
You can roll a knowledge. Let me check which knowledge it would be.
So I mean, Carrick are hoping for a few certain ones. But you've got your strong ones, and then you've got your, something like, please, not that one. Please, not that one.
Yeah, because our knowledges are...
I think they're pretty much the same.
It would be...
They're all over 10.
Arcana.
There it is.
That's fine. It's the one way... Oh my god.
Wow.
That's the one we wanted, I guess. Okay.
Diphros. Well, Carrick speaks up and said it's acid because he's green. However, Diphros, you pretty much just shut him down. You say it's obviously not acid. The green is to throw you off. He actually uses frost.
You shut your damn mouth, Carrick.
Well, I'm...
Don't be racist now. Because he's green. Doesn't mean it's acid.
No, I recommend any resistance to cold you might have.
I could give him a oil for that, yes.
And...
That is so...
Would I know any of that... Any weaknesses of that thing with that roll, or is that a new roll?
These things can regrow their heads, so they don't have much of a weakness.
Right.
However, you do know they are fast.
So aim for the legs.
Sure, he said he was gonna behead him.
Yes, let's go stop that. Let's go. Would you like to take the potion over, or the oil to him, or would you like us to do it?
Oh, I can do it.
Alright, well...
But you still need to decide on a potion.
What do you have?
I have a wide range of things. It would take me too long to explain how many potions I have.
Fair enough.
Do you have resistance to... Or immunity to, what is it, frost attacks we're looking
that
for?
That would be the oil.
Yeah, the oil.
The oil.
The potion we could look for, like...
Perhaps haste?
Yeah.
I have
some
haste,
sort of
yes.
Yeah, we could...
If we hit this thing to the max, and it grows a new one.
Damn it.
Could I ever use haste or a back, like, back skin or something to give him some natural armor? Probably haste or to match his speed. If that's what he was worried about.
Alistair might not be a total fool.
Yeah, so... Leave a haste potion
probably
and then the...
Oops, haste or something that could buff his defense. Yeah, brother.
Yeah, is there a limit here?
Yeah, just one oil and one potion.
Okay.
Have you got any potions for... let's have a... Quick Google. Said the guy.
Anyway,
the match
so...
will begin soon, so.
Well, we want an immunity to frost.
Yeah, that's the oil. That's the so we'll definitely got that. We're just looking at potions.
So what we know now is they regrow their heads and they're fast.
Yeah, so we'd even need someone to match the speed.
Probably make a choice now.
Bunker down and be more.
Tanky.
Able to add tanky and. Precise with his attacks.
Best heal?
Quick. What?
Haste, maybe?
Haste. Alright.
So, oil for frost and potion of haste.
Yes, and then we'll go to the guy again and say...
He'll hand the oil and potion over to Alistair and say that he owes the lovely dressed elf.
And Diana will turn around and say, Alistair, don't aim for his head. Those things have a tendency to regrow them.
What? But take off the head and the body will fall.
No, no. These things are...
Break the knees and they can't move.
Yes, but that...
Oh, an even better idea.
Exactly. Reduce his speed.
And I can keep pounding on them.
There you go.
Not that way.
Don't worry, I know what you meant.
We all know what you meant.
You go win, yeah? Remember, the oil and the potion you have. Use them as soon as you can.
Oh yes, I'll use them just as the match... Well, before the match starts.
Good. We'll be cheering you on from the line side.
The referee then brings out his own little horn and blows on it. The match will begin in 5 seconds. The contestants gear themselves up and ready up. Alistair finishes putting on the oil and drinking the potion.
I'm not going to be in the back row of this.
Ooh, Alistair!
They both turn to face each other, and the referee says, start. Thanks to the haste potion, Alistair gets the first turn, and he's able to charge up and aims for the knees of Munlock. Bashing in one of them, Munlock goes in for an attack with his spit. However, due to the oil, the spit doesn't do much to Alistair. And thanks to the haste potion, Alistair now has two attacks this turn, so he hits the other knee and then the knee he attacked first, making Munlock fall on his front. Munlock is now prone as he's trying to swipe at Alistair's legs, and thankfully he has the good armor and his claws can't exactly pierce through his armor. Munlock then brings up his hammer, looks at the head, and then remembers, don't aim for the head. So he hits Munlock in the back twice, and you can hear what seems to be a snap, as if his spine is broken.
Go, Munlock Alistair!
Ceases to move, and the referee moves over. Calls out for 5 seconds, Munlock isn't able to move, and announces Alistair to be the winner.
Hooray!
The human crowd cheers as the lizard folk all kind of make weird gurgling noises and everything freezes.
Yeah! Thank God we won. Yes!
Fatality.
And here we thought we were supposed to help the humans.
And here we thought we was meant to fight ourselves.
It was a trick. We were supposed to help the lizards.
Yeah. The doll says, how dare you?
You're racist assholes.
Lizard folk have been being enslaved. How dare you?
Guess we'll try the door again.
The door is open.
Huzzah!
And it leads into another room.
Huzzah. Oh god, might as well read the door. What does the door say?
The door says nothing.
Ah. What does the fox say?
And as you enter this room, there's no longer any sort of mirage or different type of area. This is definitely a part of the tower. And to the east, you can make out what seems to be three pillars with three different items adorning them.
Might as well check them out.
Oh boy.
Come on. We've done well. Jump into wait. Door? Jump. Yeah, no, I didn't. Never mind. We'll come back to it. Jump to search for traps before we carry on.
Well, he's already moved up. As you move closer, you notice that there is a ring, a crossbow, and a. Oh, pardon me. A necklace.
I'll search for traps before, just in case like there are any pressure pads out for the items.
Alright.
Yeah, wrong person. I started from the bottom and up.
Started from the bottom, now we're here.
Pretty much.
Don't find any type of traps. They just seem to be pedestals that are keeping these items raised up from the ground.
They seem safe, guys. If you wanna pick one.
Detect Majoruni.
Yeah.
These things are magical. Gasp.
Oh no.
Oh my god, who'd have thunk?
Yeah, try and take a look at them. Just all been right. Shown up over and over again lately.
Bellcraft.
Proper mage here. Pew!
There you go.
Okay, so you know what the crossbow is. And you even know what this thing is called because of your knowledges of everything. Okay, so the crossbow is called Ehlona's light crossbow. And those are the stats for it. And as you look it over, you notice it has a small compartment On the underneath of it, where 60 bolts could be stored, damn. And looking over it and looking at the bag, you think this is in a similar design to the bag of holding. And it has +1, and it has seeking on it.
Does that mean can't miss, or...?
No, it ignores concealment. So you can shoot around corners and whatnot. Yeah.
And double range, that's crazy. Well, I got this thing down, Pat. Tell you even the story behind it and everything.
Oh yeah, sorry, it also has distance. I put the brackets after seeking, yeah. Yeah. See, it also has distance, so it's double range of a crossbow.
Damn.
And you cannot identify the necklace. However, looking over it, you're thinking someone in the party has one similar.
Is it in the shape of a scale?
Yes.
Oh my god!
Telling you in-depth story, I'm like, and then there's these two things, I don't know what they are.
Do you want me to have a look at them?
By all means.
Okay, I'll use a second magic. That's two of them. As I roll some spellcrafts. So starting from the bottom.
Take magic?
Yeah, I just said yeah.
Okay.
So starting from the bottom to the... So the ring, then the amulet. The ring. The amulet.
Okay, you know the ring. And you even know a bit of a story about it.
Yeah.
Okay, so this ring is the ring of Acidic Dragon's Breath. And it contains... 3 times per day cast of the Dragon's Breath spell of a black dragon, which is a 30-foot line of acids, which does 1d8 every 2 caster levels with a maximum of 10d8, reflex for half. Or it can be used with beings that already have a breath weapon to change that breath weapon into an acid damage. Or instead of changing it to acid, they can add an additional 50% of damage to their existing acid breath if they have one.
So it'll either give somebody else a breath to cover, or help Falgor, well, give Falgor more of a range. And then...
I'll give her a third option, basically.
You what?
For the breath. Already have 2 rings, though.
Hmm. I mean, it would help anyone, really, because that acid damage could be used by anyone at any time.
True.
Is it... The caster level, does it go off the person wearing it, or...?
Person wearing it. But it needs to be a caster level, so... If, say, Falgor uses it, they're only going to get 1d8.
I'd get 5.
I have an existing breath weapon, so I could just use my normal breath weapon and turn it into acid.
Yeah.
I could get that.
Like, it would help Diana and Difrost give a bit of damage when they're just standing there in the background.
Yes, it would.
I mean, and for Difrost, that's 68.
Yeah. No, no, sorry, it's 5d8. Well, no, when we rest, it's 68.
Oh, yeah, because you have a level of rogue, don't you?
That's pretty good.
I mean, I don't think he's got 2 rings on. Bam!
Oh wow.
Okay, I double clicked it to get the information so it resizes it. And looking on the second item and comparing it to Falgor's and what he can tell you about that one, this is a Sazorius scale necklace version 1.
So I'll tell the group it's pretty much the same as what Falgor has.
Falgor has a better one.
I have a slightly better one.
Okay, it's not as good as the one Falgor has, but it's still a really good item.
It's a good item.
Well, as a frontline fighter, I wouldn't mind extra HP and lives.
Yeah. I'll give that to Carrick, just to me having the ring, and I'll say, just to me being backline, the Difrost normally uses a crossbow, if he can. However, he's not exactly the best shot.
It's true, but it does have a substantial crit range, so mm-hmm. that alone could make you
hit stuff.
Ace.
Then, I mean, we have got enough buffs, we can get enough buffs going to help it, so. And fire from the cloak.
And
stuff
like that. And there's your XP for the puzzle.
Damn.
Well, we had correct answers, are you kidding me?
Wait, you don't do stuff right. So it's like 4.5.
That's insane.
I mean, there were other ways to get through the doors, but
I was
you
bashing.
Actually solved the puzzles, so it's fine.
Yeah.
The only thing that bothers me is we never got to Barry's motive, if she actually was the killer.
Well, from this XP, you can probably gather that she was the killer.
Well, we never got her motive, except she was a bitch.
It's fine! That's all we need!
It's all in the past.
Alright, it all came down to...
Don't worry about it!
Does Difrost or Deanna have, natural armor thing?
Because
the amulet I'm currently wearing is a +1 to natural armor.
Diana has a +1. Difrost has nothing.
Okay. Have that.
Okay. Is it +1 you said?
Yes.
Okay, and then... So is it okay if Difrost takes the crossbow, or is anyone else actually...
Yeah.
He'll just
my notes, then.
He'll leave his old one. Don't want this old one anymore.
Remember to update it because it has different things like crit range.
Yeah.
The crossbow the crit range is 17 to 20.
17 range is double, so 160. Ammunition.
Yeah, that's what distance enchantment does.
So our special properties +1.
Yeah, it's just a +1 magic. Seeking and distance are both +1 enchantment abilities.
Alright, and then it has a small bag which can hold 60 bolts, so 60 in. Has it got 60 in it, or...?
No, it's currently empty.
Right, so... He'll put his bots in there. He has 19 of.
They don't wear anything whilst they're in that.
Kill.
Because that's basically the same as if Lana's quiver.
It's a shame it doesn't act as a repeating one, like a magic bag thing. That'd be great. Okay. Do you want to see if there's any other doors at the end of this corridor, or do you want to just go back? There's a black spot we can't see.
Check real quick. And we're good.
Alright. Let's go through the other door.
Alright, and as you all get ready to go to the next floor, we'll end the session there.
Alright.
Sounds good.
And if you really want, I can take you through what the puzzles were meant to do and such, if you really want to.
Yeah. Be nice to know.
So the first puzzle, which was with the room and the door saying manners, the little desk with the notes saying he tricks was basically alluding to that all those tables and stuff were meant to be like red herrings. I planned it so that you could have just done like all what you were doing, like sitting down, being all like nice to each other, or you could have tried to make everything OCD and have everything lined up. but all you were meant to do was knock on the door.
in the next room with the investigation with Charlotte Holmes. You could have actually killed anyone and the door would have opened. Like G said, an eye for an eye, you only really needed to kill someone. However, Mary was the killer, and it's not explicitly said why, but she was trying to court Dreos, and just like how she was insinuating that she kept pushing him away, which made her believe that he was as terrible with women. And you could see she's easy to anger, so she took a knife and stabbed him because she was basically shot down.
I knew it.
And then in the final room with the tournament, the door says victory, but again, leading back to that desk with tricks, just like in the room with all the murders, people were saying stuff that was like, they were kind of not corroborating their stories, or they were saying things that were different. In the tournament room, the door victory was essentially lying that it could be anyone's victory. You didn't have to choose Alistair, even though that was the correct choice in my mind. You could have just allowed Munlock to kill Alistair because that meant it was Munlock's victory.
I thought there was something like that behind us. We could have just let Munlock to win, but yeah. He wouldn't have to do anything like helping Alistair when we had to actually look through stuff and think a new strategy for him.
Yeah, why that's the correct answer, because you actually got to go through a process to interact with the room instead of saying, yeah, we'll just wait. That's why there's bonus XP for that. And you pretty much ticked all the boxes for his equipment. There wasn't really anything else you could have done with Alistair to make him better. And the potion choices were the correct ones. You were meant to give him the potion of haste.
Yeah. Yeah.
Awesome.
That's why he rushed, you say. Anyone does a double card.
No, I didn't want you to just go onto Google and then type in potion and look at a long list. That kind of breaks the immersion of you're trying to do investigative work instead of saying, oh, I have my cheat sheet right here, let me get it.
Yeah.
But yeah, that's pretty much how those puzzles were meant to be played out, and you actually did it. Don't think you're going to take so much time on that investigation one.
What can I say? Like investigations.
Thorough people.
I mean, you spent about 2 hours in that room alone.
Yeah.
Well, we've spent hours on dumber things, believe me.
So what did you say would be through the star, would be going up to the next floor?
Yes. But we'll do that next week.
Yeah. Instead, do you want to...
What, do you want to have your characters rest here?
Yeah, because Diana's only got one of her 3D6 fire things left. That's the only thing I'd really gain from this. Plus me leveling up. But I'm not too fussed about that right now.
Yeah, I mean, if we're not terribly drained and we just got some super-powered things, we are still on a timeline.
Yeah, we have 50 hours. How long has it been, would you say? Or do we have to...
Yeah, but timeline also for the meteor.
Yeah.
There's everything else that's going on outside of the tower, so, like, covering the tower as quickly as possible is, like...
So we got through half of the tower in 2 hours.
That's good time. We're making...
Yeah, definitely good.
The three of us, too.
It's because we're not having to just chase bloody Alex around.
I haven't changed the tower with just three of you either. This is meant for six people.
See?
Wow.
Moogle troop, we know what to do. What's that name? Can't remember the name, goddammit.
Constantino Farina.
Yeah.
Well, I didn't even make it and I remember it.
Yeah.
It's catchy. I'll get it down.
You know we're going to do well.
That'd be amazing.
I made that room with a little girl before I knew you had a thing about little girls fish.
Not just little girls, children. Really annoying and scary. Like, it's just...
I could show you her token as well, because the token's more creepy if you see it.
Just children. Oh my god, the eyes!
Wow. High heels, really?
Yeah.
I'm actually wearing high heels.
Yeah, that was the thing I saw following us at, like, at first.
I mean,
like,
well, that token used to be blue and didn't used to look that bloody, but I changed it a bit.
Hmm. Ah, children, man.
That's actually Alice in Wonderland as well.
Wow.
That's why her knife is called Knife of Alice.
Nice.
Oh, children.
And the tent.
Nothing, keep moving. Everything's fine.
Yeah, what the hell's with the tents? Why
tents? Excuse to put the tent.